Hello and welcome to this video. My name is Silvio Perez, and in this video, I'm going to be talking about what target CPA bidding is so you can understand it, and not only understand it, but be able to implement it and then optimize it moving forward. So to get started, go ahead and hop into your Google Ads campaign tab and click on the campaign you want to set target CPA bidding for. And once you click on that campaign, go down to settings. And then from there, we're going to click on bidding and we're going to click change bid strategy. Click it again. And then in this drop-down menu, we're going to see all the different automated bid strategies and then the manual strategy at the bottom. So we're going to click on Target CPA. And then once we have Target CPA clicked on, we can set our target that we want to reach. Now, what is Target CPA? Target CPA stands for Target Cost Per Acquisition, otherwise known as Target Cost Per Action. But essentially, it's the target result that you are looking to reach. So in the case of Target CPA, you're gonna tell Google, hey Google, I want to get leads in this example for $50. And then Google is going to use their machine learning to set your bids automatically for you, so you don't have to worry about setting bids. Google's gonna go ahead and take care of that. And they're gonna set their bids for you to make sure that you somewhere around $50, you reach that target. It can be about 20% over or under depending on the account and the amount of conversion volume you have. But usually around 20% under or over, Google is going to reach that target that you set. So it might not be $50, maybe it's $60, or maybe it's $40, or somewhere in between. But that's essentially what target CPA bidding is. You're gonna tell Google, this is my target, I want you to go ahead and take the reins, set my bids, and I don't care what you set my bids as, I just wanna make sure that I'm somewhere in the ballpark of reaching this number, this goal. And that's what target CPA bidding does. Now, there are some caveats of target CPA bidding that you should be aware of. First and foremost, you cannot do target CPA bidding if you do not have conversion tracking enabled. Target CPA bidding is all conversion focused. So if you don't have conversion tracking enabled, you need to go ahead and enable that first. The second thing as well is, even though you might just enable conversion tracking or you've had it in your account for a while, I don't recommend doing target CPA bidding until your account has enough conversion volume, enough conversion data. Google recommends at least 15 conversions within the month for your account before enabling this type of bid strategy. So really, this type of bid strategy works best when you have enough information, enough conversion data that Google can leverage so that they can make better decisions when it comes to setting those bids for you. Another thing that I've realized and I've experienced in the past is if you set target CPA bidding too soon, or if you set the target CPA limit too low. So let's say, for example, your average cost per click is $10. On average, you spend about $10 every click. And you set your target, you know, CPA limit at $10. And you know on average it's gonna cost you $10 a click. So then you know just mathematically, you're never gonna get a lead for $10 when it costs you on average $10 a click, unless you have like 100% conversion rate, which is not reality, right? So if you set your target CPA limit too low, what could happen is you end up suffocating your keywords and your bid prices, and Google's gonna set your bids so low that your ads are never gonna show. So it's just something to be mindful of. Don't set your target CPA too low where your account gets suffocated and then your ads are never getting seen, and then, you know, instead of getting more conversions, or at least conversions at a decent cost, you're not getting anything. So that's something to be mindful of that I've experienced in the past. So best practices, try to set a target CPA limit a little bit higher than what you would like, and that way you can give Google enough room. And then from there, this is the optimization phase, how you're gonna optimize your target CPA bidding is, once you set that limit, see how it goes, see how it performs, give it some time, see if Google is reaching your target CPA, if they're a lot higher or under about 20%, but just kind of see what the results are. And then from there, you can kind of taper down or taper up depending on if you want to get more conversions and you're necessarily okay with spending more and you want more volume. Well, then try testing raising your target CPA limit, maybe by $5 or $10 or a couple dollars up, and then see where you get enough conversion volume now and the cost per lead or the cost per acquisition isn't so much where you're okay with that. That's in the case that you want more volume. Now, the total opposite of that is in the case that you don't want as much volume, but you want less leads, but more leads at the right price, for example. So you're not necessarily interested in getting more leads, but you want, you're okay taking less leads, but you want less leads at a great price. So if that's in the case, then you're gonna do the opposite. And so instead of raising your target CPA and seeing how that works, you're gonna lower it. So maybe lower it by $5 or $10 or a couple dollars within that, and then see how that performs. And that's kind of how you would go about optimizing this bid strategy. So this is kind of a hands-off bid strategy. Google's gonna do all the heavy lifting for you. They're gonna set your keyword bids. So from an experiment basis, you're gonna test experimenting those different target CPA points, whether your goal is more conversions or your goal is a reduced cost per lead. You're gonna go ahead and test either increasing that target CPA or reducing that target CPA. All right, so I want to go ahead and show you an example of an experiment that was run implementing target CPA bidding and the results that were seen. And a great way too, by the way, if you're using any other type of bid strategy right now, whether it's manual, maximize clicks, or anything, and you're thinking about transitioning into target CPA, instead of just rolling out that change right away into your account, I recommend doing a campaign experiment first. And if you're not familiar with how to do a campaign experiment, you can go ahead and check out my video that I created on how to create a campaign experiment. I'll put it in the show notes in the description below, and you can go check that out. But go ahead and make sure you run a campaign experiment first. That way you can test safely if this CPA bidding is actually going to help you versus hurt you. And I want to show you a real example of an experiment ran on target CPA bidding and the results that were received. So for example, with this experiment, the results were $33.50 cost per conversion using target CPA bidding versus the original of $47.75 without target CPA bidding. And then with average cost per click, the original was about $10.10 average cost per click. And then with target CPA bidding, it was about $5.14 cost per click. In the case of this experiment in this account, the trade-off between conversion volume and cost per lead was worth it. You know, we were okay taking less conversions for a better price. So I recommend if you are interested in doing this, go ahead and run an experiment and see what the results tell you. So that's going to be it for this video. If you got some value from this, please go ahead and make sure to subscribe and follow along to the channel. I create content every week, and make sure to check out the description for the link to that video on how to create Google Ads campaign experiments if you're not familiar with that. So that's it. Hope you have a good one. See you next time. Take care.